Hey there, welcome back to Low Content Publishing for Beginners. My name is Rachel Harrison-Sund. So every week I get multiple emails from people asking why their covers keep getting rejected from KDP. So I thought I'd just do this quick little video to cover the top three reasons why your cover is getting rejected, and hopefully that sorts things out for everybody. So the first likely culprit is that you didn't include a bleed. And the bleed is just that outer edge of your document that gets trimmed off during the printing process. So let's have a quick look at that.
So this is what the KD cover template looks like once you've downloaded it and opened it. Everything in the red area is called the out of live area. So you never want to put anything of any importance within this red area in case it accidentally gets chopped off. It's just far too close to the trim. And then the part of the red area that's on the outside of the dotted line outside the trim here, that is the bleed. So having a bleed in which you extend any background images or graphics just allows for some shift during the trimming process so that you don't end up with any unprinted areas around that trim line at the end. So I'll leave a link below for this KDP cover template. I always recommend using one. It's very helpful.
Now, the second culprit, and it's something that can be really easily overlooked, is that your colored background or background images aren't extending all the way past the trim and all the way to the edge of that bleed. So let's take a quick look at what I'm talking about here.
Okay, so I've got this gorgeous book cover example here for you, and this black line represents the trim line, and the red line represents the edge of the bleed. Now, it seems to be perfectly fine, but as you zoom in closely, you can see that my blue background doesn't actually extend all the way to the bleed. We're only talking less than a millimeter here, but it doesn't matter. It has to go right to the end. So when you're creating your files, just always zoom in to all four corners and just make sure that your background image or color does extend all the way to the edge of that bleed.
The third one is that you entered your book title incorrectly during the publishing process. Seems to be a lot of confusion out there about this one. It's the one that I get the most emails about, but you have to enter your book title exactly as it appears on your cover or spine, or it absolutely will get rejected. Now, the confusion lies around people browsing Amazon, and they see that people have these really long-winded titles, and they seem to be getting away with having way more than what's on their book cover entered into that title field. So let's go ahead and take a look at an example here, and we'll clear up that confusion.
So as you can see with this example, this book has a very wordy title, and most of this title does not appear on the cover. So what is going on here? Well, all you have to do is look for that colon, which we can see right here. So everything in front of the colon is what has been entered as the actual title. So the actual title has just been entered as Boss Lady, which is exactly what appears on the cover of this book. Everything after the colon has been entered as the book's subtitle. So the rule, like I said, is different here. You do not have to enter your subtitle as it appears exactly on your book cover. So this is where you can add a few extra keywords. Now, don't overdo it. You don't want to be keyword stuffing. Make sure it sounds natural. And then what we've got after in the brackets here, this is what has been entered as the series title, which you can choose to use or not. It's totally up to you. So even though this title looks like quite a mouthful, you can see that this publisher has actually entered the title in accordance with KDP rules.
So I hope that clears up any lingering confusion about why your book covers might keep getting rejected from KDP. And now you're well equipped to go ahead and provide some print-ready files that are up to spec. So thanks for watching, guys. Hope you got some value out of that. And you know, as always, if you want some more low-content publishing tips, you can check out my blog, rachelharrisonsund.com. You can hit subscribe to get notified every time I put out one of these videos, and you can download my guide if you want 3 steps to publishing your first low-content book in less than a day. All right, thanks for watching, guys. Have a great week. Bye.